Fighting the zombie hordes with a chainsaw duct tape to our boom pole, this is ENN. So, there's a game-breaking glitch in Metroid Other M. Nintendo knows about it, but the Wii doesn't have any way to patch games remotely. So, the only solution is to put your game on an SD card, in an envelope, and mail it to Nintendo. They will correct the file and mail it back to you. Despite all their many advances in technology, Nintendo's tech support is apparently trapped in the time when Nintendo was founded, the year 1889.
EVE Online developer CCP has announced plans to make an MMO based on Vampire the Masquerade. The game will apparently focus on player politics and social interactions. And with this, CCP have achieved the almost impossible feat of making a game based on sexy vampires sound really, really boring.
Phil Spencer, VP of Microsoft Game Studios, has said that the Kinect will succeed and will not, quote, be the 32X, which is fine because there's a nearly endless number of beleaguered Sega peripherals we can compare the Kinect to that aren't the 32X. The Sega CD, Sega Satellite, the Enforcer, Sega Channel. Does Sonic and Knuckles count as an accessory? Judges say yes, but it wasn't that bad. The Kinect, then, is the Sega CD.
And now, Jeremy and Paul investigate the truth behind Sony's marketing directives and yaybuttons.com.
Thanks. To prove the superiority of the Move over Microsoft's Kinect, Sony has launched a new website, yaybuttons.com, a celebration of the concept of a button, a move that many people think is very weird. Yay Buttons is presented as a stream of consciousness narrative about the merits of buttons for video game controls, but it quickly devolves into a series of ruminations about how nice the word button looks, and an acrostic poem about buttons. It is not even a very good poem. They couldn't even come up with something for the second T. It is almost like they wrote it completely at random. For more on this story, we go to Jeremy Petter.
In an effort to better understand the motivation behind yaybuttons.com, I traveled to Sony Computer Entertainment America to speak with Ian Fox, Junior Vice President of Marketing and Public Relations.
We created yaybuttons to give us a place to showcase how important those small knobs are to gamers. People are so used to having buttons in their lives, they don't even realize how much they do with them. We think Yay Buttons has been immensely successful in that regard. The free-flowing narrative of the website was the idea of our Executive President of Marketing and Public Relations, Mr. Stinky.
Who is this mysterious Mr. Stinky? Can we interview
him? No. Mr. Stinky values his privacy. He's a reclusive type and he dislikes interviews immensely. I would strongly advise against attempting to speak to him.
So Mr. Stinky is some sort of anthropophobic marketing guru?
Oh, no. Mr. Stinky is a hamadryas baboon. He becomes extremely violent and temperamental when he meets new people. He tried to tear off my kneecaps when he met me.
I see. What?
Since hiring Mr. Stinky, Sony has been able to save over $350,000 a year in salary alone. Baboons will work for a selection of tender grasses and insects. And don't require extended health or dental benefits. We considered other types of monkeys, but we settled on a baboon because of their natural ischial callosities. Those butt pads they have make them perfect for jobs that require long hours of sitting at a desk.
So your boss, Sony's executive vice president in charge of marketing, is a baboon. How does he make decisions exactly?
Pretty much the way any other monkey would. We put everything up on a big board, and whatever he hits with his own feces, we run with.
Wouldn't it make more sense to pick ideas he didn't put his feces on?
Well, his aim's not good, and Mr. Stinky has chosen some internationally lauded campaigns. He personally approved the Kevin Butler initiative.
Back to you, Paul.
And there you have it. Those Marcus PSP commercials make so much more sense now, don't they? What's next for Sony? Who can say? But what is certain is that for Sony, marketing isn't so much serious business as it is monkeying around.
Thank you, Paul, but you really should have said monkey business. That would have been really funny.
Mm.
So, are you excited? Guess what came out this week? The new Deer Hunter!
Oh, really? Oh, excellent. I love the Deer Hunter games. I go in to pick them up and they're like, you know, you're the only one who pre-ordered this? And I'm like, really? But they're such excellent games with just really like photorealistic graphics and stellar gameplay. Most importantly, I hate animals, so it's fun to shoot them.
I was actually talking about Deer Hunter, the band.
Oh, okay. I'll shoot them too.